Shalom to the hopeful elect of the nation of Israel, giving all praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Rakak Wadash, double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone that rule well, and peace, blessings, and salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. I'm the brother Yawanathon, coming from the great millstone West Palm Camp, and Lord, in this lesson, be edifying. And, you know, as I was reading, the book of Exodus, the 9th chapter, you know, the scriptures, the scripture speaks about how the Heavenly Father will raise up a Pharaoh, all right, in this modern day Pharaoh, you know, the modern day Egyptians, all right, we know them to be Esau, we know them to be the Edomites, okay? So the Heavenly Father, as the scriptures say, is going to raise up Esau in these latter times, all right, to do what? All right, to magnify his power. Okay, again, the Heavenly Father is going to raise up Esau, Edom, okay, not only just to show his power, to show how powerful he is, but to destroy him, just like how he did the ancient Egyptians in that time, man. Okay, so let me start at the book of Exodus chapter 9, and start at verse 12, and the Lord, Yahweh, hardened the heart of Pharaoh, and he hearkened not unto them, as the Lord has spoken unto Moses. You see, so in these latter times, what the Heavenly Father, okay, has raised up his servants, the prophets, okay, that's to prophesy. Prophesy means to say before, all right, to tell these people their judgment, to tell them that America, Babylon the Great, is going to be destroyed by ICBM nuclear missiles, okay. And what do? You know, in these latter times, they're going to try to, you know, gather up the men of the Lord. They're going to try to put hands on them, and they're going to try to persecute them. Okay, so Esau, Edom is not hearkening, just like how Pharaoh didn't hark, you know, in ancient times, right? Okay, in verse 13, and the Lord said unto Moses, rise up early in the morning and stand before Pharaoh and say unto him, thus said the Lord Yahweh Selakia, thus said Yahweh, the power of the Hebrews, let my people go, that they may serve me. For I at this time, let me read it again. For I will at this time send all my plagues upon thy heart, and upon thy servants, and upon thy people, that they mayest know that there is none like me in all the earth. You see, so Esau, Edom is so proud, all right, and we understand that Esau has a god complex, man. You know, Esau, Edom, you know, is running around the earth acting as if there is no power, there is no god. Okay, that's why in the book of Isaiah, the 10th chapter, it speaks about the stout heart, you know, the stout heart, and that's going with Esau, man. You know, if you ask Esau, Esau will act as if, they're the ones that's doing everything, man. Okay, let's go to the Isaiah, the 10th chapter, okay, for further context. Okay, this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 10. And let's throw that verse, okay, let me get the point. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 12, and it reads, wherefore shall come to pass that when the Lord hath performed his whole work upon Mount Zion and Jerusalem, I will punish the fruit of the stout heart of the king of Assyria. This is speaking about Esau, Edom, all right, because the modern day Assyrian is Esau, all right, speaking about you so-called white people, okay. And it reads, okay, and the glory on his high looks, man. All right, going back again, you know, backing up the book of Exodus, the 9th chapter, man. You know, after the Heavenly Father punishes this place, after he punished Esau, then they're going to know that there is none like him, man. All right, because again, Esau, Edom acts as if he is the Most High, man. Esau acts as if that the Heavenly Father is not the one that's orchestrating all these things that's happening upon the planet Earth, man. That's why it says the stout heart, man. All right, a heart meaning mind, you know. And let me jump down to verse 15, all right, just to show you. All right, Isaiah chapter 10, verse 15. Shall the axe boast itself against him that heweth therewith? Or shall the saw magnify itself against him that shaketh it? You see? So, hey, is an axe going to praise itself? Okay? Because hey, without the person manhandling or using the axe, hey, it really can't do anything, man. All right? And it says, as if the rod should shake itself against them that lift it up, or as if the staff should lift up itself as if it were no wood. You see? So again, hold on, let's go up to verse 16. Therefore shall the Lord of hosts send among his fat ones leanness. All right, meaning that Esau, Edom, all right, is going to lose all his money. All right, he's going to lose all his riches. All right, and Esau, Edom really doesn't have any riches when you think about it. All right, especially when you go to the dollar, the Federal Reserve. All right, we know the paper notes is really worthless, man, because real money is supposed to be backed by gold and silver, man. Okay, and we know that this current dollar is not really backed by anything. All right, and that's why it's always depreciating. Okay, and it says, under his glory, he shall kindle a burning like a burning of a fire. And that's again representing them ICBM nuclear missiles, man. And that's going to be the future of this place, man. Okay, and before, all right, this place gets utterly destroyed by missiles, all right, hey, the Lord is going to what? Hey, the Lord is going to send a fanners unto this place, man. All right, that's Jeremiah the 51st chapter. All right, hey, Jeremiah the 51st chapter, it speaks about how the Lord shall send fanners against Babylon, man, that shall make her desolate, roughly paraphrasing, man. Okay, so you're going to see, you're going to truly see, hey, the power of Yahweh Shemal Shah, man. All right, you're going to see a famine of food. You know, the brother Azaria from Orlando was going into it yesterday, man. How you got individuals fighting for food at Aldi's, man. All right, showing you that this place is going down, man, minute by minute, hour by hour, man. Okay, day by day, month by month, man. We're closely seeing the end of this place, man. And that's why, hey, you had all the men of the Lord. What did they write about, man? They wrote about how the time was short. All right, Romans the 13th chapter and the 11th verse says how what? It says how it's a high time to awake out of sleep. All right, for your salvation is nearer than we believe. Okay, it's high time to awake out of sleep. Why? Because hey, this place is going down, man. Okay, and this place America, hey, this place America is gonna go through it like how it's never went through it before, man. Thus said the Bible. Okay, so let's go back to the book of Exodus, the 9th chapter. All right, and let's go down to verse 15, Exodus chapter 9, verse 15, and it reads, for now I will stretch out my hand that I may smite thee and all thy people with pestilence, man. Okay, and that's what's coming, pestilence, man. All right, pandemonium, destruction, mayhem. That's what's coming to the streets of America real soon. Thus said the Bible. Okay, the second Exodus, the 15th chapter goes into this as well, man. All right, and verse 16, Slakia, verse 15, it says, and I shall be cut off from the earth, and in very deed for this cause have I raised thee up, for to shew in thee my power, and that my name may be declared throughout all the earth, man. And after the judgment, or after the you know what, after the Lord did unto Pharaoh in Egypt, and you have people speaking about that, you know, and we have heard what your power, we have heard what your God Yahweh Shemal Shah have done unto the Egyptians, man. All right, that's in the book of Joshua. Okay, so hey, this is gonna happen to the modern day Egyptians, which are you Edomites, man. Okay, the modern day Egypt is America, thus said the Bible. It says how we shall go unto Egypt again into ships. That's the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Okay, and I also wanted to get the book of Romans. All right, Romans chapter 9, Romans chapter 9, verse 17, and it reads, "For this scripture said unto Pharaoh, even for this same purpose, I have raised thee up, that I might shew my power in thee, and that my name might be declared throughout all the earth." You see? So that's lining up what we just read, man. So the Heavenly Father raised up Pharaoh to utterly destroy him, man, just to show his power. And that's what he's going to do to Esau, Edom, man. All right, Esau, the most wicked. He is the wicked, Salakia. All right, so what is the Lord going to do? The Lord is going to put him out the way, man, take him out the way. All right, and this is what we're waiting for. All right, for wickedness to be executed throughout all the planet Earth, man. All right. And, you know, I'm going to just grab this last scripture, okay? Just, you know, I'm doing a little in transit, you know, before I go to fellowship with the Akim. Okay, this is 2 Ezra chapter 15, and I'm going to just get the point. 2 Ezra chapter 15, verse 10. "Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them to dwell in the land of Egypt. I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof." You see? So it says as before. So it's just to show you, it's not speaking about ancient Egypt. It's speaking about a new Egypt. All right, and we know Egypt is symbolic unto what? It's symbolic unto a captivity, man. Okay, and it says, "Egypt shall mourn, and the foundations of it shall be smitten with a plague, and the punishment that the Most High shall bring upon it," man. You see, so that's what's gonna happen, man. What you're gonna see that's gonna happen to America is the punishment of the Most High, man. Okay. Hey, the scripture, Ezra said, woe is me, who shall deliver me in them days? The Lord is about to send heavy judgment upon the planet Earth, man. And so you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans have to wake up and come back to your power source, man. Okay, because it's going to get real dark out here, physically and literally, man. All right? So, Lord willing, this lesson was edifying. To the next time, giving all praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh Bahashem. Yahweh Shah Bahashem Rechakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone every well. Peace and blessing unto the elect. Till next time, Shalom. Abba Baba, Kormiya Sha'Allah. Shalom.